Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a spread in my movie and TV show journal for the month of May. So I watched quite a bit of movies and TV shows in May. Let's just get into it. So like last month, I'm going to put down the washi and the titles and stuff, and then I will come back and talk about the shows. So here is the little collection of movies and TV shows that I watched this month. So let's start ticking them down. So now that I've stuck down all of my shows, I'm going to, like I did last time, write the names and then where I watched it or who I watched it with, and then the rating.
Thank you.
So that's my spread for May. I just put a few stickers, some Halloween stickers, because I watched a couple of Halloween movies. I put some little Netflix little stickers here, and pizza because we had pizza a couple of nights, and then tacos. And then it was my birth month in May, so I put a little birthday cake. So as I was editing, I realized that there was a lot of noise in the background as I was sticking down my shows because people decided to walk past my house. And yeah, so I'm just gonna go through the shows and the movies that I watched this month. So first of all, we have Wizards of Waverly Place. I watched that on Disney Plus. I just watched some random episodes because I was just eating lunch or something and just watching a couple episodes. Next is End with an E on Netflix. I continued my binge watch of that. Outlander, I know it's finished. I waited till the season was over to watch the episodes. So I've got a few episodes left till the finale. So Never Have I Ever on Netflix. I loved that show so much. It was so good. My dad and I continued our little binge watch of Smallville on DVD. We watched two up to season 10 at the moment, so I'm sure it'll be in the June spread as well. I started watching Wentworth because I heard really good things about it and a lot of people have recommended it, so I started watching that. I really liked it. It was on Foxtel. And then I watched The Corpse Bride. It was a rewatch on Foxtel because it was like a little marathon. They had The Corpse Bride, Nightmare Before Christmas, and Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, so I watched those three straight after the other. We finished our binge watch of Lucifer. Loved it so much. It was such a good show. I cannot wait for the next season. Then my dad and I decided to watch the Shrek movies. I started watching them and then my dad sat down and decided to start watching them with me. So we watched all four of them over like 4 days. We like watched one a day and nothing beats the original, but I did like the other three. Two of them were rewatches. I don't remember if I've seen the fourth one before, so we just watched it anyway. I didn't write rewatch because I don't know if I've actually watched it before. And then, like I mentioned before, Nightmare Before Christmas was on, and then I watched Kiki's Delivery Service on Netflix. Love that movie so much. It's such a great movie. If you have any other recommendations of Studio Ghibli movies to watch, leave them in the comments below because I'm always looking for new ones. I have quite a few in my Netflix list that I want to watch, so yeah. And then, again, like I mentioned before, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. It was part of that little marathon that was on. And then A Mermaid's Tale. I watched that one night. Nothing else on TV, so I decided to watch it on Foxtel. Not a fan of it. Wasn't really that great of a movie. So that is my May watched spread for my TV show and movie journal. I'm really loving the way this journal comes out. It's really colourful and just really great way to look back and see what shows I liked, what I didn't like, and what I've watched. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I really hope you enjoyed my video. Please don't forget to subscribe and give this video a big thumbs up, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye.